Welcome to Love Where You Live, your monthly magazine of the best of Sheboygan County from the Sheboygan County Chamber. I'm Betsy Alice, Executive Director at the Chamber, and today we're welcoming Tammy Graff, our Director of Workforce Development with the Sheboygan County Chamber. Just as background, Tammy was hired in early 2015 to establish a major program of work around workforce development. It had become obvious that the success of our companies would depend more and more on our ability to attract and retain talent here and to ensure that our schools were providing career exposure and experiences that would develop meaningful career paths for them and to keep them here in our county. Welcome, Tammy, to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
You're very welcome. You've been with the Chamber, as I said, for quite a bit under 2 years.
Yeah.
And, you know, during that time, you have been establishing this work in this new role for you and for the Chamber, a brand new position.
Right.
Why do you believe workforce development plays such a vital role within the Chamber these days?
Well, as you said in the beginning, there's definitely a talent shortage that we're experiencing here within Sheboygan County and as well as across the state of Wisconsin. Our baby boomers are retiring at an increasingly fast speed. And there really aren't enough people to replace those vacancies. As far as the next generation, we're looking at 9 million people that are less, so it's 11% decrease. So there is some vacancies and there are some issues there. So then you also bring in the fact that we have the brain drain. So for some of the younger talent that we have here in Sheboygan County, you know, taking opportunities outside of our area. So I think that actually, that workforce talent shortage is really the biggest reason that for this position here and what we're trying to do at the Chamber to help to address that, because it's also become an economic issue. So we're here as the Chamber to, you know, help our businesses, because if for some reason we can't find the talent, there is the talent shortage, you know, that affects our businesses' ability to operate on a daily basis. It affects their ability to expand, and it becomes an economic issue for them and then for our community as well. So the role that I see as the Chamber playing and what we're trying to do collectively here is to convene our members and to facilitate conversations between our businesses and our educators and community leaders to see how we can solve this issue together. And then also to serve as a resource for our members to provide, you know, issues to help with their different dilemmas and with their different issues as well. So
lots of tools, lots of strategies.
Yes.
And I think too, the relationships that they have with each other within the Chamber are also very helpful. Our roundtables, for example, bring some of these people together, and this issue comes up a lot.
The dialogue is very important, right?
As part of your work, you facilitate the Business Education Partnership Committee.
Correct.
And can you just tell us that? What is their role and how do they, what is their body of work?
Okay. Well, first I'll explain what that is. The Business Education Partnership is really a group or a committee that it contains, we have five different school districts on board as part of the team. I will say three of those are superintendents. One is an assistant superintendent. We have a principal of both a middle school and a high school. We have the manufacturing sector represented from the business side. And from that, we have the leadership as a chief operations person to an HR person, professional to help with that. We have HR in healthcare represented. We have the youth services from Great Lakes Training at the job center there. We've had mental health is a big piece of this as we move forward, as that's an issue within the schools. So basically what the group does is, the mission, I will tell you, is to, you know, provide programs and community outreach to support workforce development. This particular group has been in existence for quite a few years, and just to give an example of some of the things that they have accomplished or that they've collaborated on that have been very successful is Coastal Young Professionals Network. That's, we also have Inspire Sheboygan County. That was actually a brainchild that came out of conversations within the Business Education Partnership. And then our Career Connections, which is the giant career exploration event for all Sheboygan County 10th graders, 1,500 students that the Chamber has been hosting this event for several years now. I want to say like 10 years. It's been quite a while, maybe even a little bit longer. But there's about 120 different volunteers from businesses that, you know, all congregate at LTC, who is our partner in hosting it, together with Inspire over the last several years. And it's an opportunity for our Sheboygan County 10th graders to learn about different career opportunities, to pique their interest, but then also to learn what opportunities are available right here in Sheboygan County. I think oftentimes people kind of overlook the fact that Career Connections is a retention piece as well, because they're making that association with this career, with this company, and if I'm interested in this and building those relationships, you know, this is a great place to come back to, because I can come back to Sheboygan County and do what I love to do and live in Sheboygan County. So
right, yeah. And I remember someone referring to it as kids learning that inside these boxes they drive by are some very interesting, intriguing companies that they might one day love to work for. Mm-hmm. So if we can expose them to that through that variety of programs, that's a wonderful thing. Mm-hmm. And I think parents will appreciate that too.
Yes.
Those especially who would like to have their kids kind of settle close by.
Yeah, very much.
So yeah, and you talked a little about it being an economic issue. I think that can't be underscored enough.
No.
Our companies are expanding now, and so their need is very urgent. And as we develop these tools, you know, we bring the human resource audience together to try to, you know, deploy those tools to them so that they can take advantage of them. That's one of the benefits of them being a member of the Chamber.
Absolutely.
So yeah. Can you share a few initiatives, and you just shared a few of them, that this committee is tackling to encourage students to pursue these career paths?
Absolutely.
Maybe a little more about Inspire and a little more about Career Connections.
Absolutely. So we'll start with Career Connections. So we have our next one is scheduled for April of 2017. We expect about 1,500 students. It is mandatory for all of those students to participate within the Sheboygan County School Districts, which is very helpful. We again have 120 different volunteers from different, you name it, from construction to manufacturing to healthcare to finance, accounting, all across the board.
Even entrepreneurship and small business.
We do, yep. And I think this year what we're really focusing on and what will be very beneficial is we're actually bringing in, we did bring in the counselors this year to help us with that particular curriculum so that we can actually start working with the students prior to them going into Career Connections so that we can utilize Inspire Sheboygan County, which I'll get into very shortly, and what those work-based learning programs are. So it's a continuum. So it doesn't just serve as one event that the students just go to in a day. So it's a piece of the whole continuum of career exploration and what we're trying to do.
And that's a big change.
It is a big change.
Because I've been here about 6 years now, and initially it was kind of a standalone event. Mm-hmm. And now, through the work of this committee, I believe, and your help, just developing that continuum, or even sometimes unearthing that continuum.
Yeah.
You know, things that already exist that people just didn't know about, and now we connect the dots so that people see it as a continuum.
And the fact that volunteers want to be more proactively involved in the process of even developing it and how that can be. So this year what we're looking forward to, we've been working with LTC on this as well, we are having a huge orientation for all the volunteers at one time. So they have an opportunity to meet as a group beforehand in February. They learn a little bit more about what we're expecting, and they're going to be more a part of developing what their presentation is together as a group. Mm-hmm. So it's we're looking for interactive to to keep those students interested. But then this gives them an opportunity to meet ahead of time, to make some plans, to be on site so they can see what their rooms look like, what they have to work with. That makes a big difference in what's going on. So again, I think this goes back to the Chamber chamber and what we're trying to do, and being that conveners and the collaborators and bringing everybody into the process, mm-hmm. you know, which I think is really huge.
And I think, too, just kind of gently keeping the pressure on to raise that bar.
Correct.
Yes. Each and every year has gotten better and better.
Yes.
And in the process, I think these volunteers who present actually can come away with a set of skills.
Definitely.
That maybe they didn't have before they started.
It's definitely different presenting to, say, if you're trying to make a sale versus to a group of 10th graders.
Mm-hmm. So it is indeed. It's great. Yeah. No more talking heads and PowerPoints with bullets.
Yeah. No. So it's fun. So, and you had mentioned then about Inspire Sheboygan County. So I'm privileged to serve on the board of Inspire Sheboygan County. And that's actually a really important initiative because the goal behind Inspire is to provide work-based learning opportunities for students within local companies so mm-hmm. that not only are they learning about different careers, again, they're also building those relationships with local companies, you know, as part of that retention process. And that is going to become even more important. Inspire will play an even larger role up and coming because the state of Wisconsin is now requiring, as of 2017, that all mm-hmm. schools at least offer academic and career planning to their students. To my knowledge at this point, there's no specific curriculum, but Inspire will be critical in mm-hmm. making those connections and helping with that career planning.
Definitely.
Yeah. The platform that they use is Career Cruising, and that was actually the platform that the state of Wisconsin has selected for the schools to use. So we're doing pretty good as far as, you know, not having to recreate the wheel. We're very mm-hmm. fortunate. We're about 3 years ahead of the curve as far as getting this
Which
up and running.
Excellent.
Yeah, it's wonderful. So it's going to be a big influx of students taking on more of these opportunities in work-based learning. So the businesses will play an even larger role than what they're currently even doing as well.
And if you're parents, you've probably heard of Career Cruising.
Yes.
From your kids. We encourage you to also take part in that with them. Have them show you how it works and what's involved. It's basically a software program, an online mm-hmm. program, where the students can actually talk to career coaches in the various interest areas that they've indicated. So mm-hmm. it's a pretty amazing thing. I happen to be a career coach.
Yes.
And I get a lot of fun questions to answer because there are a lot of categories I've worked in my life. And it's an eager, interested mm-hmm. group of kids. So and there are thousands of them signing on now.
Yes, there are.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And many of our companies are directly involved now. So I was there at the very beginning,
yeah.
and I know how much it's grown. So really significant program. Inspire Sheboygan County, it's called.
That is correct.
And I believe there's a website.
Yes, there is. And you can actually access it through Career Cruising, because I think it's important because a lot of the students mm-hmm. Know it as Career Cruising.
Right.
And I think sometimes there might be a little confusion as to where Inspire Sheboygan County kind of connects with the Career Cruising. And so Career Cruising is a general and an awesome website to be able to, you know, for students and yep. their parents to explore different careers. But then Inspire Sheboygan County is the link that's on Career Cruising to connect those students to the companies and to the career coaches. So if they want to take it a little bit further, if they want to explore, so, you know, I'd like to be a doctor or I'd like to be a nurse,
right.
but I'd like to ask a few questions. You know what, I'd like to do a job shadow. I'd like to tour this particular company. Those are the opportunities available through Inspire Sheboygan County.
So, nice. Excellent. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I encourage people to go out there and mm-hmm. take a look. In fact, you can just Google Inspire Sheboygan County too. And,
yes, you can.
And come up
yeah.
with it, which is my favorite thing to do now. So I'm going to switch gears just a little bit. Last year, we had more than 200 educators and business leaders and community leaders
yes.
In a very large room having a wonderful interactive discussion about workforce development. It was our first Workforce Development Summit.
Yeah.
And this year, we're heading into our second Workforce Development Summit. And you know a lot about it because
yeah.
you're heading it up.
Yes.
I'd like to just revisit last year briefly, just to kind of give people some background about how that worked and what maybe the top three items that came out of that gathering, that conversation, were.
Okay. So we wanted to make it a conversation. This is the first time that our members in our community really got together to have this conversation and talk. So we decided to make it a facilitated conversation, and the half day was basically, it started with a panel of, we had the Sheboygan County Economic Development Corporation, we had the Chamber, we had a member of SHRM, our president, and then we also had Dan Mella as a curriculum assistant superintendent of curriculum. Okay. We also had business and education partnerships that were already in place, successful, and what those would look like. We had Mike Trimberger from South High. We had Dave Graber from Aurora as part of that healthcare and what that looked like. We had Louis Gentine along with Dr. Carrie Dassel from Plymouth School District and what their whole food science and then their tech ed program was like. And so what we would do then after that is after each presentation or after each panel discussion, we broke out into sessions. There was a facilitator at each table, and we asked the questions. So what do you think? You know, what is our strengths and our weaknesses of our workforce development efforts? Mm-hmm. Again, what are these opportunities and threats that are facing us as a community? So after each, I would say, break, we would have a few tables report out, and at the end, again, report out. And I think what was so powerful about this particular summit was that conversation, and to be able to voice those concerns and to share the concerns and to see, you know, what everybody else was thinking, what everybody else is doing. So collectively then, we asked everybody to kind of fill out their own form of what they felt was the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. We collected over 1,000 responses, 1,000 plus, and kind of categorize that. And by we, that would be the Business Education Partnership. Mm-hmm. From there, we narrowed down our priorities and at least what the community members felt was going to be with those priorities. And it came out to be that we're looking at concerns with our resources, a lack of and an alignment of resources, particularly in the areas of mental health, transportation, and obviously talent. And then the other piece to that would be our perceptions. There was a concern about our perceptions, a lack of branding in this area, and how difficult it is to attract people to Sheboygan County. And then finally, talent development. You know, that's always an issue, and we always touch on
that for sure.
So those, I would say those were the three largest.
Okay. And then this year, it's a full day event.
It is.
And just if you can kind of, it'll be September 29th at Lakeshore Technical College.
Yes.
That'll give us a little more space. We're expecting more people. And what do you have planned for this summit? What are the highlights and the goals?
Well, the goals of this one, we wanted to make sure that we went full circle so that we could at least address those areas we just talked about. So we do have a very large panel. So we have Representative Paul Tittle, who is the chair for the Mental Health Reform Committee for the state. We have Representative Terry Kotsma, who is on the Workforce Development Committee, and then we have Tyler Vorpagel, Representative Vorpagel, who is also on the Transportation Committee. And then we have people, the EDC, who is also going to be talking about what those transportation initiatives are that they've been doing to address what came out of the summit. Same thing with the mental health. You know, basically, what are we doing on the state level? What are we also doing on the local level to address what our community members and our chamber members, you know, consider concerns?
And what are the gaps?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And where do we need to go? So then we're also having some awesome breakout sessions this time to kind of do a deep dive into some of those particular areas of resources, talent development, and then talent attraction. We have Angela Damiani, who is the president and CEO over at Milwaukee Young Professionals. She's actually going to be our keynote speaker, and I'm really excited, talking about bridging the generation gaps, and that's a really important initiative of theirs, and actually with Coastal. So we have the Milwaukee Commons coming. There's an initiative that's really awesome for entrepreneurship and innovation that they're going to be high probability of doing here. And then we also have the Green Bay Packers mentor-protege program that we are going to be setting up here with throughout the chamber, and they will be there to talk about that. So fun stuff.
Wow, lots of things going on. Definitely lots of things. Please, if you're interested, you know, go to Sheboygan.org. That's Thursday, September 9th, our second Workforce Development Summit. So, Tammy, just in closing, can you share with us some of the regional and statewide initiatives that you're currently involved with, some that we haven't talked about, and what you hope to accomplish with this work?
Well, actually, I serve on a committee of the Governor's Council on Workforce Investment. It's called the Partnership Development and Resource Alignment, and that's a really wonderful. We're trying to basically align all those resources, what we're talking about from local, but as a state level, and which all the, you know, the thinkers from the different chambers and from the different organizations and different agencies throughout the state are a part of this. And it looks to be doing what the chamber is doing, but only on a much larger scale. So it's really exciting stuff.
Very nice. Very good stuff. And I was pleased to see you were appointed to
that
commission.
Yes, thank you. Yes.
It's an honor for the chamber and for our community at large to have that representation. Well, you know, is there anything in closing that you would like to tell our audience about upcoming things?
We definitely have, you know, we have an HR and realtor tour coming up.
Yes, important one.
Yes, on August 17th. That is part of our initiative that we are working on to help our to learn to sell the area a little bit, to point out the highlights. Our relocation specialists are the keys to the gateway here.
Yes, they are.
And the welcoming our newcomers, as is our recruiters and our HR. So to learn how to do that and to see what's available. And just as a reminder, we get into our little corners and forget. So.
And that's August 17th
yes,
and
it
18th.
Is. Actually, the 16th and
17th. 16th and 17th.
Mm-hmm. That's right. That's right.
I was doing that from memory.
Yeah.
And they'll be having a reception the evening before and then a full day of touring the following day.
Right.
And along with that, as you said, there will be a little fun sales training.
And actually, that's at the reception.
Great.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Well, Tammy, I'm so glad you were able to join us today. Yes. I know how busy you are.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Love Where You Live. Today I wanted to spend a little bit of time talking about a program of the Sheboygan County Chamber that a lot of people don't know much about. It's our travel program. For the past 4 years, we have traveled to faraway places as a group through the chamber, but not necessarily having to be chamber members. It's more to bring the community together, to travel together, to experience something new. We've gone to China. That was a fabulous trip. We had about 22 people who went with us. We've been to Italy. We had about 20 people who traveled to Italy with the chamber. And our last trip was to Ireland, and we had 32 people traveling with us that time. So the program is growing. And each time the people come back, I have to say, almost ecstatic about the experience. And a lot of what they love about it are the people they travel with. So what this does is helps build relationships that are really important. Our travel in 2017 is going to be to a very faraway place, Australia and New Zealand. The sign up for that trip is early, and so that's why I want to bring it up now so that you have a little time to consider it. We have a special offer on this travel, which will take place from March 7th to March 21st in 2017. Right now, it's $600 per person less than the actual price of the trip. And that's through September 9th. So I note that right up front so you know. I want to tell you a little bit about this trip. I've been to New Zealand many, many years ago. And it was that inspiration that led us to begin to explore this travel. What I love about the trip we're offering, it's through Colette Travel. It's door-to-door, which means you'll be picked up in the Sheboygan County Chamber parking lot and taken to the Milwaukee Airport, which is our departure site, which is also very convenient. We have the option of 3 extra days in Fiji at the end of this trip also. And Colette Trips always feature some of the finest hotels in the area. A lot of our meals and a lot of the tours are included in the trip. And the total price tag for this trip is $6,059. It sounds like a lot of money, but if you do some research on this kind of travel, you'll find that it's a very, very good value. And that price lasts until September 9th. Our itinerary starts with that pickup at the Chamber. We're going to arrive in Cairns, Australia first and spend some time at the Great Barrier Reef with a biologist in a catamaran, and we're going to have the option of snorkeling and an additional trip that even goes further into the reefs for people to consider. We're going to visit the Tapukai Aboriginal Cultural Center, where we can learn to play a didgeridoo, throw a boomerang, and learn some of the native dances. So this will be a highlight of that trip as well. Then, and this is one of the things I love about this, we don't spend a lot of time on buses. We fly to Sydney. It's a long distance. That city tour of Sydney, of course, includes the famous Sydney Opera House and the National Opal Center. So they're famous for opals. If you love opals, this will be your opportunity. You'll want to bring some extra money. We have a lot of time for independent exploration and a lot of optional tours on this trip. There will be a dinner cruise of Sydney Harbor. We're going to then, after several days there, we're going to fly to Christchurch, New Zealand. And that will start our New Zealand part of the adventure. We'll have dinner actually with a New Zealand family where we'll have home-cooked food and really get to know some people who live there and be able to ask a lot of questions. We're going to visit a sheep farm, of course. Maybe we'll see a shearing. And we're going to go to some fruit stands to see what kinds of produce they have. Optional journey through Middle Earth to the remarkable mountains where the Lord of the Rings was filmed. And you might also choose to take a jet boat ride on the Shotover River. What I want to do now is show a short video so that you can actually experience some of these things and see if they're the kinds of places you'd like to go.
I can't really pick one site over the other. Each one is a new adventure, and I would come back on another trip anytime. This is a trip of a lifetime.
We having a good time?
Yeah! Unbelievable. We're here in Ayers Rock. I'm sipping champagne. This is what an experience. And we've got an anniversary, too.
It's memorable. I won't forget it, the way it happened, everything.
Salud!
As well as coming to Australia, that writing a balloon was on my bucket list, so I've done it.
Yeah. Two kangaroos.
Sydney Harbor Cruise is one of the great experiences of the whole trip. You get to relax with all of the passengers and enjoy the rest of the night, and the pictures were just some of the best pictures I took during the whole trip.
Now off to New Zealand.
Bye!
I'm panning for gold. Hopefully I'm going to be able to fund my retirement.
Sadly enough, we have only a few days left. I wish it lasted a little longer.
Okay, so that looks pretty good, huh? If you're interested, please go to Sheboygan.org or call the Sheboygan County Chamber for more information. We'll be happy to help you. I am going to be going on this trip, very excited about it, and my husband is also going with me. So we have 10 seats left, just 10 seats. So please, if you're interested, let us know right away. We want to save one of those for you. There's no obligation until September 9th. You put your money down. If you change your mind, you can have it back. But please consider joining us for Australia and New Zealand travel in 2017. Thank you very much for being here, and I'll see you next month.